वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स स्टैंडर्ड 7th, थर्ड चैप्टर HCF एंड LCM पार्ट 6. नाउ दिस इज द 6th पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो टुडे वी विल सी प्रैक्टिस सेट 14.
नाउ सी स्टूडेंट, प्रैक्टिस सेट 14, क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू टू डिजिट नंबर इज 765 एंड देयर HCF इज 3. व्हाट इज देयर LCM? नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इन दिस क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट्स, हियर द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द टू टू डिजिट नंबर इज गिवन, दैट इज 765 एंड देयर HCF इज गिवन 3. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द LCM. सो सी हाउ यू विल गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द LCM ओवर हियर. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू फर्स्ट वी हैव टू राइट डाउन द स्टेटमेंट. क्लियर? व्हाट स्टेटमेंट you will write down? You will write down the statement that is the product of given number is equal to HCF multiplied by LCM. Clear? This statement you have to write down. Now, our product of two digit number is given 765. So here you will write down 765. And the LCM is not given. HCF is given, that is 3. The LCM is not given. So you will write down as it is. Understood, student? Now how you will do the calculation over here? Now here how you will do the calculation? This 3 you will take on the left hand side. So multiplication will become division. Clear? And the right hand side LCM will come as it is. So how you will divide? 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. 1 we have to carry with 6, it will become 16. So 3 fives are 15. Again you have to carry 1 with 5, it will become 15. 3 fives are 15. Means here your LCM will be 255. Understood how you will do this, everyone? Now see student, question number 6, which two consecutive even numbers have an LCM of 180? Now here we have to find out that which two numbers have an LCM of 180. So how you will going to find out that? Let's see. Now see, first what is given in the question? The LCM of two consecutive even number is given in your question. Clear? That is 180. So the LCM of two number is 180. Now we have to find out the HCF. HCF of two consecutive even number. Clear? So what you will write down? The HCF of two consecutive even number. Did you know? So students, keep in mind that whenever you have to write down the HCF of two consecutive even number, the HCF of two consecutive even number is always 2. Clear? Now what you will do? We have to find out the product of HCF and LCM. So our HCF is 2, LCM is 180. So what you will get? You will get, that is 360. 360 is the product of HCF and LCM. Now further what we have to do? We have to find out what two consecutive even number. So what you will do now is you will find out the factor of this 360. So let's see what are the factor of 360. So student, factor of 360 is, see what are the factors of 360. So what are the factor of 360? The factor of 360, we have to write down all the factors of 360. So what are the factor of 360 over here? Did you know, students? Now here the factor of 360 is, first of all the factor of 360 is 36 multiplied by 10, you will get 360. Clear, student? Now the next factor is 40 multiplied by 9 is also 360. Clear? And 18 multiplied by 20 is also 360. So these all are the factor of 360. Now which number you will take whose LCM will be 180? Did you know? No. So what you will do, how you will take that is, here we have to take whose difference should be 2. Clear? You have to take the factors from this whose difference is 2. So let's see, 36 multiplied by 10. Now 36 and 10, is the difference between 36 and 10 is 2? No. Is there is a difference of 2 between 40 and 9? No. Is there is a difference of 2 between 18 and 20? Yes, there is a difference of 2 between 18 and 20. It means which is the factor, which is the 2 consecutive number whose LCM is 180, that is 18 and 20. Clear? 18 and 20 is the 2 consecutive even numbers whose LCM is 180. So how you will write down? Therefore, the required, you have to write down the required consecutive even number is 18 and 20. Understood how you will do this? So like this you have to solve this sum. Now see students, 7th question. A trader has 3 bundles of string 392 meter, 308 meter and 490 meter long. What is the greatest length of strings that the bundles can be cut up into without any leftover string? Now student, what is given in this question? Now here the 3 bundles of string is given, that is one of 392 meter, 308 meter and 490 meter. So what you have to do in this, we have to find out that in what length a trader should cut this string so a trader should not get any leftover in that bundle. Clear? So further it is given, that is, what is the greatest length of a string? Now greatest means what you will do in this question? You will find out the HCF or you will find out the LCM. Now the word come greatest. Greatest means the highest. It means in this question you have to find out the HCF. HCF of what? HCF of this 3 number. So let's find out the HCF of this 3 number. So first it is given 392. Then second it is given, that is 308. And then it is given, that is 490. We have to find out the HCF of this number. So how you will going to find out? Now all the 3 numbers are divisible by which number? That is 2. 2 1s are 2. 1 carry with 9. It will become 19. So 2 9s are, you will get 18. So again you will carry 1 with 2. So it will become 12. So 2 6s are, you will get 12. Now again 2 1s are 2, 1 you have to carry with 0, it will become 10, 2 5s are 10 and 2 4s are, you will get 8. 490, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 1 you have to carry with 0, it will become 10, so 2 5s are 10. Clear? Now 196, 154 and 245 is divisible by which number? All the 3 numbers are divisible by 7. Clear? Now 19 is there. 19 is not there in 7's table. So smaller number is 14. So 7 2's are, you will get 14. So 19 minus 14, what you will get? That is 5. 5 you have to carry with 6. So it will become 56. Now 7 8's are, you will get 56. Now second one, 15. Here, so here you will take 7 2's are 14. 1 you will carry with 4. Again it will become 14. 7 2's are 14. Now 24, 24 is not there in your 7's table, smaller number is 21, so 7 3's are, you will get 21, so 24 minus 21, what you will get? 3, so 3 you have to carry with 5, it will become 35, clear? So 7 5's are 35, so our remainder is 28, 22 and 35. So all these 3 numbers are divisible by which number? Can you tell me all the 3 numbers are divisible by a single number? No, all the 3 numbers are not divisible by a single number. So we will stop our factorization over here. So what will be your HCF? For finding the HCF, what we need? We need our common factor. So our common factor is 2 into 7. So what will be your HCF? Your HCF will be 14. क्लियर. सो वॉट लेंथ अ ट्रेडर विल टेक टू कट दैट स्ट्रिंग. सो अ ट्रेडर विल टेक अ लेंथ ऑफ 14 मीटर टू कट अ स्ट्रिंग. सो इफ अ ट्रेडर विल टेक अ लेंथ ऑफ 14 मीटर, सो नो लेफ्ट ओवर स्ट्रिंग ही विल गेट इन हिज बंडल. क्लियर, अंडरस्टूड एवरी वन. सो वॉट यू विल राइट डाउन हियर, नाउ वी हैव टू राइट डाउन दैट द ग्रेटेस्ट, देयर फोर greatest length of string is 14 meter. So a trader will take a length of 14 meter. Clear? Now see student question number 8. Reduce the fraction into the lowest term. Now we have to reduce this fraction into the lowest term. Means we have to find out the HCF by the division method. Clear? So see how you will going to find out. Now what will be our dividend and divisor? The smaller number will be our divisor and the bigger number will be our dividend. Clear? So 348. is our dividend and 319 is our divisor. So 319 ones are, you will get 319. So carry 1 from 4 with 8, it will become 18. So 18 minus 9, you will get 9. Here 3 is remaining. So 3 minus 1, you will get 2. And 3 minus 3, you will get 0. Clear? Now 29 will be our divisor. And what will be our dividend? The previous divisor will be our dividend now. Clear? So 29 elevenza, you will get 319. Understood everyone? So what will be our HCF over here? Now what you will take your HCF? This last divisor you have to take as your HCF. Means here your HCF, the last divisor is 29. So your HCF is 29. Now we have to reduce this fraction into the lowest term. So how you will reduce? See, 348 divided by 319. So what is our HCF over here? 29. So we have to see whether this number is divisible by 29 or not. Clear? So yes, it is divisible by 29. 29 12 is 348 and 29 11 is 319. So 29 29 will get cancelled. So here your answer is 12 upon 11. Understood? How you will reduce into the lowest term the given fraction, students? So like this you have to solve.
Thank you everyone for watching this video.